Toughest car.
Spicing that one, mate.
Are you okay, mum?
Hello.
Taffy.
Hello,
how are you? Spicing this one.
Thank you.
Shut up. Mass for Panyin Peter Okujia is going to take place. Languages are right, so very soon we'll be taken inside and then we can start the service.
should go with Kenny. Just yourself, or is there anyone else that you think will know out?
I want to see if there's a
you can. Yeah, okay. We'll have to be like 12 o'clock anyway, so you've got a little bit of time.
Alright. Well, thanks.
Oh, yes, and yes.
Just wait a second, gentlemen, please.
Thank you.
still got my phone. Yeah.
Thank you.
dear ministers of God, dear family and friends of our dearly departed Mr. Peter KWAKU, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the host pastor of this church, I wish to welcome you all to Cornerstone Church today. The late Mr. Peter KWAKU had one request, simple but profound. We are not gathered here to mourn. He asked us to gather to celebrate a life well lived. The word of God says it's 70 years, but he has been blessed, pressed down, shaken together, overflowing 104 years. So his wish is that we come here to celebrate his life and to give thanks to the Almighty for blessing him abundantly. Amen.
Amen.
My name is Elder Katie Abuke from the London Ghana Seventh-day Adventist Church. From the same church is Pastor Fergus Osu Boateng. Please give us a little wave. He'll be giving us, leading the service and giving us the word of life. Elder Oteng, also from the London Ghana Church. And then we'll have Pastor Stewart and Pastor Carla Payne. If you're here, give us a wave. They will lead us out in the worship. We also have Pastor Dora Kakari here, please. God bless you for coming. And then we have Minister Georgina. Is she here to give us a little wave? Oh, okay, when the time is come, we'll get to see her. We are ready to start now. So I'll please ask you to do this. Something that keeps embarrassing us, our mobile phones. I have checked mine. Please double check yours, put on silent, or please switch it for us. Trust me, at the wrong time it will ring and cause embarrassment. So please double check. Thank you very much. So invite the female director and the pastor to come and ask you please rise as they bring the body.
If a man dies, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time, will I wait till my change come? Thou shalt call, and I will answer thee. Thou wilt have a desire to the work of thy hands. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever, or over, thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting. Thou art God. Like as a father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame. Remember that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field. So he flourishes, for the wind passes over it, and it gone, and place thereof shall know it no more. But by mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto children's children. So to such as keep his covenant, and to do that remember his commandments to do them. Amen.
Should we stand? We're going to spend some time.
I'd like to invite Pastor Dora Kakari to please come and give us the gathering words and opening prayer, and then we'll go into that. Thank you very much.
Not by our power, by the Spirit of the Lord. Bible says there's time to die, to be born, and a time to die. We all know that one day we all will be called. It is ready in times like this when we gather. We have to prepare ourselves. We have to ask ourselves, when we are called like today, what will happen? Where are we going to be? So, our dear Father, that we're here because of Him, He loves worship. He loves praising. And so we are going to praise. We are going to worship Him. We are going to worship to that extent that, yes, Lord, God Himself will take absolute control. And so, Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. Take absolute control for the whole service. As we heard earlier, our dear daddy, he loved praying. He said he wanted enough to worship as well. He wanted us to celebrate him. And so, Lord, today, take absolute control. Take away every pain, every sorrow, every disappointment, every failure. And let us focus on you, Lord. Your word is our life. So, Lord, take absolute control and have your way. Touch the entire family. Whatever that you alone will have your way. God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, worship through your worshipers, those you have delegated for them to come and stand in your presence to worship. Father, we thank you that inspire them so that we shall all be filled, we shall be delivered, we shall be all again waiting for you. We thank you for everything that you have done. Today is another great day. We'll continue to praise and thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. And the same say,
Amen. Amen.
Where all the other
Every breath that I am in.
Thank you, Pastor Stewart and Pastor Adam, all the way from Portsmouth. God bless you and take you back safe. Came all the way from Portsmouth this morning. I'd like to invite Minister Georgina, if she yes. Minister Georgina, please.
Still, my heart and tongue employ. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. With me exalt his name. When in distress to him I called, he to my rescue came. The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the God whom we adore. Be glory as it was, is now, and shall be evermore. Opening Peter Quick. KWAKU Jia, as his peers affectionately called him, and known to his family as Daddy, was born on the 7th of May 1918 at Inkrine in the Ashanti region to Nana Kwabena Bonsu and Nana Ama Ade Ejapong, forgive me, the tree's not coming out today, birth of blessed memory. Opening Dia was the only child from their union. His mother then had four other children, giving him two brothers and two sisters. Daddy Duah was raised in Ashanti, Newtown, and Adum Kumasi. He started his primary and middle school education in Kumasi and after got into the trade of shoe and suit making. He then started trading from Kumasi to Togo, where he would buy and sell shirts and other items to the training college students. By this time, Daddy Duah also had at least six young men as apprentices learning how to make suits. Daddy Duah was not a Christian from the beginning. He always used to say he loved life and had a friend called Mr. Yao Che, a devoted Seventh-day Adventist, SDA, who had almost persuaded him to give his life to Jesus, but he always refused. Then one night he had a dream and saw the heavens open and Jesus stretching his hands towards him. He continued saying his room was filled with the most beautiful light he ever seen, covering the floor and every part of his room. When he woke up, it was Saturday morning. He went straight to the bathroom, got ready, and went to his shop to let the young men he thought know his shop was not opening that day and would no longer open on a Saturday.